Hello. Let's start from the beginning. I really like my microcontrollers. They allow me to do fantastic projects. Unfortunately, they cannot handle large currents. For example, it is very easy to make a small LED light up. It is more complicated to handle power outs like these. For this reason, about a month ago, I made a video about the IC CN5711, which allows you to handle power LED up to 1.5 amps. Today we will see how from this circuit I made and assembled this amazing Arduino Nano compatible PCB. Hi, I'm Dario. I am a maker and want to share my ideas with you. Please subscribe to my channel to support my projects. I want to thank the first sponsor of this video. PCBWAY is an online service specializing in PCB manufacturing and assembly, CNC machining, 3D printing and more. With one click I can order my board at very reasonable prices, from $5 for 10 PCB. With the link in the description you can get an extra $5 discount. The boards look really professional and very accurate. The text, although very small, is readable and clear. Looking at them already gives me new ideas and corrections for a second version of the PCB, but we will talk about that in another video. I was so happy with the arrival of the package that I immediately tried to assemble a board with the components I had at home. The result is not elegant, but it helped me test how well the board worked. At this point, I want to thank the second sponsor of the video. AEP Electronic Assemblies is a local company that specializes in electronic design and assembly. It provided me with the components and expertise to make this board. Thank you guys so much for supporting my projects. The circuit is made from a few components. Two resistors, a diode, a CN5711, a button, and, of course, the LEDs. As you can see, I soldered the components by hand, only using the soldering iron. It is probably more correct to use an SMD stencil, solder paste, and a heated plate. Honestly, I found it a bit tricky to solder two SMD resistors. Perhaps the 0603 package is a little too small to solder just with the soldering iron cleanly. However, the result of soldering is functional. I think a magnifying glass or a digital microscope and a third-hand kit also help a lot to make clean and accurate soldering. I think I will have to make shopping soon for my lab. Good. The assembly looks good to me. Now I have to test if the board works. I put the power supply on 4.2 volts like a lithium battery. I loaded a simple firmware just to test the functioning. With each push of the button, the power LEDs power up on a different way. The test, I think, was successful. For this test firmware, I used not too high currents, as we can see from the power supply screen. I actually had to write a bit more complex code than expected to achieve this result. Don't worry, in the next video, I will explain all the code. I think I will finish the video now. Don't worry, I will make more videos about this board. Especially on how the circuit works and how to program the board. In the meantime, I will leave in the description all the links you may find useful. For all doubts and questions, please write a comment. I will try to answer you as soon as possible. I am Dario, I am a maker, and I would like to thank you for visiting my channel. Bye bye.